Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Mo Mods, Mo Dodge, or Mo Dodge, Mo Mods, however you like it. Today we are unwrapping another modification upgrade to the Dodge Charger RT. We have the Hellcat or SRT front bumper primed and ready to be painted. But for the most part, this is the packaging it came in. It's pretty nice. I'll leave the description and the location in which I purchased it. It was on eBay. It came fully packaged with the grill and all the components needed, which is pretty neat, roughly about 500 bucks. But for the most part, let's get started. So right now, guys, what I'm doing is just pretty much unpacking the inserts, which is required for the full installation, just to get an idea of what it looks like. I'm pretty sure the inserts don't need to be painted, but I'm gonna have the bumper definitely painted the color, the original color of my car. I'm just gonna wrap it, but that's just too much work. And for the cost, it's about the same as the material required for the initial, the covering, if you will. All right, so let's go for it. As I stated, I definitely got the grill, which came with fiddlesticks. Came with the components needed for the fog lights. Actual bulbs themselves, or the fog lights themselves, were purchased separately. But it came with the bezels, it came with the inserts, the brackets required for the installation of the fog lights. And they don't need these painted, so I won't need them. For the most part, as you can see, it was very well wrapped. Very surprised at how well it was wrapped. Wrapped so well, I had to bring it outside to open it. I just didn't have enough room in the house. So here we got, what is this, the bracket insert for the let's see. Here's the actual grill it came with. Of course, I got the 19 bezel grill coming out. It'll be here probably today, tomorrow, but that's the bezel. Just the grill that it comes with in the packet. It's not bad. I guess I could sell it. I'm not going to use it. But hey, baby. What? You see all this stuff? That's your count. Go ahead. Lower grill, which I am going to use. Making sure all the parts are here, you know. My handy dandy exactly right. That That is some serious packaging right there, man. This thing, packaging this had to take at least an hour or two. Because it took me that long just to unpack. At least it feels that way. Alright. Here we go. Here's the bumper insert. Look at that. Nice and clean. You know, that stays the same. Just to give it that offset effect. Here is the actual lower grill. So I don't need to change. But look at that. Brand new. Let's see how, I hope it fits just as good. Because you know, when you buy non-Mopar parts, they don't necessarily always, whoa, what's this? Oh, that ain't good. We found a broken piece, guys. See, that's what I'm talking about, quality. Let's see where it came from. Luckily I'm not, oh, this is the Lord. Yeah, baby. I'm not sure if I did that or that's how it came, but as you see how it was packaged and how I took it out, I'm going to do a review, but it shouldn't have came off and it looked like it did. They're kind of flimsy. So, who knows? Blew that back on. But it shouldn't make a difference. Fog light bezels, let's make sure everything is in there and not broken. Right side, it's the right side, and it'll probably go in like so. Clear. Fog light.
Clear.
Right.
Clear. It's
the money. All right, and let's take a look at the actual bumper itself, just to make sure there aren't any scrapes and things of that nature, because I might have to actually put it back in this packaging and take it to the take it to get it painted. So let's just make sure everything's okay. And what I'm going to do, guys, is I got my hood coming in as well. It should be here by the end of the week, although it should have been here before the bumper, before the bumper line 2 weeks ago. I ordered my hood a month ago. Still haven't come in. So fiberglass hood, AmeriHood.
So guys, I'm just explaining here, the unraveling of the package. You guys gotta forgive me for the low value, but stay tuned and let's keep watching.
Another one, so that kind of proves to me that this was broken before I got it. What I'll do is I'll let the box seller know that these parts are broken upon delivery. Maybe they'll give me a new one, maybe not.
As you can see, guys, this is a lot of work just taking the plastic off of the bumper and all the inserts and things of that nature. Needless to say, I finally got the hood wrapped and the bumper, front bumper installed and painted. And so I'll be sure to give you guys updates, but right now this is just the unpackaging, unboxing of the parts.
See it in all its splendor, for the most part. Wish it was already painted. That's the one thing that sellers don't do, is they don't offer it already painted. If it was already painted, I could be putting it on my car right now. But it's all good. Considering the price, I think I've had a decent deal, with the exception of these two broken pieces. So this over here has fuel holes down there. It doesn't come with any nuts, screws, or anything like that, which I wish it did. So, I'm going to have to figure out how to do that. I guess, I don't know if this needs to be broken.
Alright guys, what just arrived today is the SRT bumper. The box came in, and look how it's curled up. Interesting. It's very flexible. Get something to open this up with. But yeah, that's the rear bumper. I'm going to open it up, let the sun heat it up a little bit so it can breathe, and then we'll return. Thanks you guys for tuning in, and I'll keep you guys posted on the next scheduled delivery.